In this video, we'll be answering the question, what is aggregated current? Now, this question relates to a number of videos that we've made in association with Wago, and specifically to their connectors used in maintenance-free situations. So please go and check those videos out if you haven't already seen them. Now, the more thorough electricians among you have got used to the idea of maintenance-free connections when using Wago connectors such as the 221. And we've come to realise the importance of following the manufacturer's instructions in order to achieve a truly maintenance-free connection. For example, by using the correct connector type in the correct box and making sure that the box has been sealed up with a cable tie in the case of the Wago box. But this issue of the aggregate current is one that is still causing some confusion. So what is it and how do you find it? Well, one of the key things that a junction box has to deal with is how it handles the heat created by current passing through the conductors in the box. Heat is a function of the power dissipated by the current passing through the resistance of the conductors and the connectors. It's found by using the formula P equals I squared R. Now notice that squared over the current there. That has a massive impact on the power and therefore the heat. If the current goes from 1 to 2 amps, it doesn't just double the power, it quadruples it. Therefore, a small change in current creates a large change in the heat created. Now, we need to take account of all the heat created in the junction box, and we do this by considering the amount of connections in the box that current passes through. So if you've got a simple connection of line, neutral, and CPC in and out, current flows through the line connector, through the load, and then comes back through the neutral connection. So if you have 1 amp flowing through the load, that means that the total, or aggregate current in the junction box is 2 amps. If, however, you've used a junction box to make off a 3-plate connection to a downlight, you've got the current through the permanent line terminal, off to the switch, and back through the switch line terminal, through the load, and then back down the neutral. So if you've got a load of 1 amp, the aggregate current in that junction box is actually 3 amps. Now, of course, this may also be connected to other fittings further down the circuit, meaning that the current through the permanent line and neutral terminals may be even higher, and the circuit could always get added to, thus increasing the aggregate current further. So to make sure that you're below the maximum allowed aggregate current, you need to take the maximum possible current that could flow through the box and multiply it by the number of terminals in the box. So if our junction box here was protected by an MCB with a nominal rating of 6 amps, we'd multiply 6 amps by 3 terminals, which gives us 18 amps, which is well below the 50 amp maximum aggregated current. So that's an introduction to this subject, and I'm sure you've got lots of other questions on aggregate current. So please leave any of those in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.